Thank you, Mr. Rivera. I wanted to apologize to Mr. Castellani because I said that you represented the Business Roundtable Institute for Corporate Ethics, and apparently it's just the Business Roundtable.
I am president of the Business Roundtable.
Yeah.
I am a member of the Board of Directors of the Business Roundtable Institute for Corporate Ethics. That's probably...
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, thanks for clarifying that.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm here on behalf of the members of the Business Roundtable, who are the chief executive officers of America's leading corporations. Collectively, they account for more than $5 trillion in annual revenues and 10 million employees, but most importantly, they provide health care for 35 million Americans. I appreciate the invitation to testify, and I share the urgency of this committee and the fellow panelists that health care reform must be addressed now. Today, I want to focus on three key messages. First, we need to get health care costs under control. Second, we must preserve the coverage for those 132 million Americans who receive that coverage from their employer. And third, we need a reformed insurance marketplace so that individuals and small employers can afford and find affordable coverage. Let me address the draft legislation that you have before the committee. First, let me thank you and the committee for moving forward on health care reform. We view that as very positive and necessary, and we want to be constructive in what we believe will work and what we believe will not. We support the provisions that reform the insurance market so that there are more affordable coverage options. The bill also includes a requirement that all Americans get health insurance coverage and includes auto-enrolling for individuals into SCHIP or Medicaid if indeed they are eligible. We support both of those provisions and also support offering subsidies to low-income Americans who cannot afford coverage. The changes that you have included in the Medicare programs and other efforts to make our health care system more efficient are very positive. Medicare payments do need to be adjusted, and we'll provide the committee with comments on these and other issues. We do, however, have significant concerns about two major issues in the draft legislation and hope that the committee will consider some revisions. First, ERISA should not be changed if reforms are to be built on the employer-based system. The proposal before you would change some of the ERISA rules. For example, it would impose minimum benefit packages on our employees. Large employers design innovative plans, including wellness and prevention initiatives, that have been tremendously successful in helping employees take greater control over their own health. And yet such programs, which we believe are critical to the success of health care reform, would be jeopardized by a new federally mandated benefit law. Second, we're very concerned about public plan proposals that would compete in the private marketplace. As large employers, we're concerned that our employees will suffer from additional cost shifting that come from inadequate government repayment to the providers. For that reason, we're concerned that the kind of cost shifting that we're dealing with now would be exacerbated. Further, the government plan could erode existing worker coverage if employees seek a subsidized, lower-priced public option. That would diminish the people in our plans and would leave employer-sponsored coverage with more expensive, more costs for both employers and employees. Innovation, which we think is the key modernizing our healthcare system and getting our costs under control, benefits improvements, and how best to care for patients, we believe come best from the private marketplace. We need to preserve the energy and the commitment to improve our healthcare market, and we're concerned that government plans cannot do that as well as the private sector. We urge the committee to instead create even stronger rules to make the private insurance marketplace more competitive, and we want to help in that effort. Business Roundtable believes that the search for bipartisan consensus can begin by honoring the principles that we've outlined in our written testimony and by crafting reform that is consistent with the uniquely American principles that drive our economy: competition, innovation, choice, and a marketplace that serves everyone. On behalf of our members, we pledge to work with you and all the members of the committee to find workable solutions that let people keep what they have today in a reformed healthcare system that works better for everyone. Thank you.